Hello, and welcome to a recap of today's Python and Django live code hangout. I've been working on the OpenCivi Wiki project today. I took a task to update our continuous integration pipeline, where we're using GitHub Actions, to now use the Poetry package manager instead of pip. This involved several other changes and improvements along the way. Including changes to our linting and code formatting that were largely inspired by the project that we took to install Poetry. The documentation was ex excellent. Let's just go ahead and read through this from top to bottom, though, in case you're wanting to set up Poetry for your own Python and Django project, the continuous integration pipeline. So we'll just go over our CI workflow here from top to bottom. So we just call it CI workflow. Continuous integration. So every time we have a pull request on the develop branch or a push, means you're still working on, you open a pull request and you keep pushing to that, it'll dispatch this, it'll run these jobs. Broadly, we called them Python tests. It's essentially testing the code as well as the style of our project. Currently, the pipeline runs on Ubuntu, which is where we're deploying our code. We may enable support for running the pipeline on Mac OS X. I don't know what the computational costs that would incur, or if we would incur any financial costs for doing so. So I'm going to keep it simple and just run on the latest version of Ubuntu. And we run several steps here. So we're trying to use prepackaged actions. So we've got a action to check out the code. An action to set up Python. I upgraded today to the version 2 of this action, so just kind of keeping up the house. We're recommending a minimum of Python 3.10. That's kind of what we're testing out to make sure it's stable on that version. If you're running Python 3.8 or 3.9, you'll probably have good luck. But it's, if possible, just use PyEnv and install the latest Python that you can from the 3.10 series. Most of the rest of this came from this snock install Poetry project. The documentation is excellent and goes far beyond what would be needed just so I could learn how to run the job. It introduced all these other steps, but essentially we install Poetry here, and we're going to install more or less the latest, as of this moment, version of Poetry 1.2.1. We have some Poetry configuration variables here. We want to create the virtual environment in the project directory and install things in parallel. I guess that'll speed things up a bit. If possible, we want to cache these dependencies so that this is one of the slower parts of the pipeline. If possible, if our dependencies aren't changing, we don't want to have to keep installing those every commit, every time I push. I didn't see this take effect in action. Again, this came straight out of the documentation for snock install Poetry. So if you're wanting more information, it's a really well documented GitHub Action component. The README here is very comprehensive, goes into detail, gives very thorough examples. I didn't go through this line for line by any means, but actually, this is something crucial here, this code coverage upload, which we'll be doing in a moment on this project. So what this is, above and beyond what you would need for just installing Poetry. Really kudos to this Snog, which seems to be a development open source collaboration or a collective based in Norway. Thank you very much. So continuing onwards, we look for the dependencies if they've been cached. If not, we're going to install them. So we're installing dependencies if there's no cache hit. So it's just running Poetry install. And then we run the project migration. So now we're getting back into the regular project stuff. Since we're using Poetry now, we're going to prefix all of our commands with Poetry run in the Python command or whatever the other command is. Same thing. So when we run tests, we have a couple of environment variables that were set up prior. So I didn't want to interfere with those if they're still needed. We're running multiple commands here. We're changing directory into the project. Then we're running PyTest inside of the Poetry environment, and we're not producing any warnings, I guess. Then we run lint. using PyActions Flake 8, which previously on this configuration we were, I think, running the link command manually. I don't remember, or Flake 8 version 1, something changed here. Nonetheless, this is like the latest, so if you're just wanting a recipe to follow, don't worry about what changed, but this is what's working currently. We've got a couple of rules that we'll ignore, and some files to exclude, namely the migrations. I believe with Django 4.x series, the auto-generated migrations should be black compatible, which is what we're using to kind of in Flake 8 compatible, perhaps. I don't know if we need to still exclude those. Black prefers a maximum line length of 88 instead of 80, which is one slight difference between Flake 8 and black. So to harmonize those, you just configure that. By default, this runs in the root of our project, and the root of our project also contains a virtual environment, but Flake 8 doesn't really know it's a virtual environment. It just sees it as a folder with a bunch of Python files. So to avoid Flake 8 linting our whole virtual environment, I just told it where the project source code is, so because that was producing a bunch of errors, and those are out of our control. The last thing, I added some Flake 8 black support and Bugbear support. If you're interested, Bugbear produces some additional warnings about possible bugs you could be introducing in your code and anti-patterns that are a little bit above and beyond what normal flaking or linting rules, even the Flake 8 rules, would produce. So it's kind of giving a little bit more rigor to your linting step. And black, again, is an opinionated formatter, and we're using it in our project, so we want to make sure that the Flake 8 and black are working well together. So that's it. All you needed was an example of a continuous integration workflow on GitHub Actions, you could literally just copy this code and it should run in your project more or less with minor changes depending on the structure of your files. The only other change we made during this live code session was to remove some constraints on the black configuration so that it would no longer ignore certain folders like our migrations. So I've removed some code here. And I've changed our minimum recommended or minimum compatible Python version. Oh, I thought I dropped it down to 3.9. I'll probably bump it back up to 3.10. And we did mess around with our dependencies a bit, but nonetheless, it's not so important. So this pull request can be viewed here at github.com/openCiviWiki pull request 1330. You can see there was quite a lot of changes, including linting. And finally, at the end here, we pass all of our own tests. And that's what we're aiming for with this. We want to enable our continuous integration pipeline to run successfully using the Poetry package manager for dependency management and running the commands. Okay. Well, thank you very much for your time. I hope you're doing well out there. Have a great day.